Hello, I'm Sam and welcome back to the Rough Tools channel. I'm going to show you why every electrician needs these ideal Generation 2 wire connectors in their tool bag. Let's have a closer look.
Taking the 5-piece lever here, I'm going to compare it to its leading rival, and we can see size wise it's thinner, it's a little bit longer, again it's thinner on that dimension too. Also with its leading rival, the levers open in the opposite direction to the Gen 2s, which I think is better because as you push the cable into the hole you can clamp it down at the same time in one fluid motion. I can just demonstrate that here quickly with a bit of 2.5 solid. Job done. Another great feature with this is that you can just push the solid core straight in without actually having to open the lever, and it's got a very, very good hold on it. Again, you just lift the lever and it comes out. So fantastically reusable as well, which is great. Taking 4mm cable, do the same thing again. It will just push straight in, a bit tougher with the 4mm. Again, completely locked into place. Again, just lift the lever, a bit tougher with the 4mm, but it does just come out. Taking 0.75mm stranded, what you have to do with this cable is, it obviously being flex, you can't push it in, so you do need to open up the lever straight in there, lock it out again, really good tight grip. And just as an example, I thought I'd put a boot lace ferrule on the other end of the flex, and that will just push straight in like it would do if it was solid core. Really, really good grip on that. There are the testing points here. You can just about see it. And again, on the rear for your probes. On the back, there's a line across there that says 12mm, which is obviously the gauge for stripping the cable. I think these are an excellent piece of kit.
I think these are currently one of the best connectors on the market. Rated at 32 amps, and you've just seen how versatile they are with the different types of cables and even using the boot lace ferrules. I'm definitely putting these in the back of my van. I'd love to hear from you if you're going to do the same. What are your thoughts on them? Are you using them already? Are you about to use them? Please let me know. And until next time, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and give us a thumbs up, and I'll see you in the next video.